Hello, Bruins. This video will teach you about the features shared by our Ebsco databases. If you're new to library research, I recommend watching our database basics tutorial before this one. If you've ever searched in the databases before, you might have noticed that the page looked different depending on the database you were in. This is because our databases come from different places, and generally the databases the library gets from the same place will look the same. The majority of our databases are provided by EBSCO, including Search All Resources, so this is the layout that you will see most often. If you're in an EBSCO database other than the Discovery platform, also known as Search All Resources, you will normally see this page, the Advanced Search, when you enter the database. You can learn about this page in our Advanced Database Skills video. It lets you apply all your filters before you even begin searching. But if you find all the options here overwhelming, you are able to simply type your search term in the box at the top of the page and immediately go to the search results. The search results page is also where you begin in Search All Resources. Every EBSCO database has your search terms at the top, as well as your account options, which we will get into in a minute. You also have your search results in the middle column and your filters, or ways to narrow the search, on the left. The filters may be a little different depending on which database you are in, but you'll almost always see options such as publication date, scholarly only, full text only, and source type. These are your most frequently used filters, but if you see a new filter in a specific database, I encourage you to check it out. It's probably something that will help you with the specific subject area for that database. For example, CINAHL has special headings that will help you research in the health field. To read or learn more about a document, you can either click the title to reach a detailed record of the item. This detailed record will have a link to the full text along the left, along with options to save the source on the right. Options such as Google Drive and the citation tool are among the most useful here. And in the middle column will be information about the source, including the author, abstract or the summary, and the publisher. You can also click the full text link under any document title in the search results page to read the article right away. You can still find those options for saving the source along the right side of the page if you do this. One of the best things about EBSCO being our main database is that it allows you to make full use of the EBSCO folders feature. At the top of the database, you will see the option to sign in. The first time you do this, you will need to set up a new EBSCO account, but once you've done that, every time after that, as long as you are signed in, you can access your account, no matter which of the EBSCO databases you are in. You can then use the Add to Folder option found within any source. When you're signed into EBSCO, you can create different folders, let's say one for English 151 and another for Comm 101 as examples. And then, as you have different research projects for those classes, you're able to keep organized which sources you are considering using for each class, and it's easy to find them again. Just sign in the next time and click View Folders. So that's EBSCO. If you have any questions, please feel free to get help from the library, including through our 24/7 chat service. Thank you for watching.